Welcome to MMA Oddsbreaker. I'm Nick Kalikas. Joining me today, I have Case Kiefer and Damon Martin. Let's get started. Fight number 19 comes to us from UFC Fuel 10 in Brazil, a heavyweight battle between Fabricio Werdum and Antonio Rodrigo Nogueira. We're going to start off with Case first on this one. I'm going to open up Werdum as a slight favorite, minus 170. The comeback on Big Nog is going to be plus 130. Case, with your five dimes donated bankroll, give me your take and give me your bet.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy to look at this fight and realize there's only a one-year difference between these guys because age-wise, because at least when you think of perception, and my perception certainly is that Fabricio Werdum at 35 is constantly improving. Looks like he's kind of reaching his peak, whereas Big Nog at 36, to me, looks on the downside of his career. He still put on some good fights for us and entertained, but I don't think he's quite the fighter he once was, and I just really favor Fabricio Werdum in this fight. I think we both know they're great, both great on the ground. I think if you're picking Nogueira, you think that he can catch him on the feet or pick him apart, but I really think Fabricio Werdum's stand-up is very improved. I think it's looked great in just about every fight over the last 2 years. I mean, even against Alistair Overeem, he kind of lost that fight by acting goofy and pulling guard, but he held his own standing up, and if you can do that against him, I think that he's going to be able to do it against Big Nog, and I really like Fabricio Werdum at this price.
Okay, so Case is going to lay the juice, minus 170 on Werdum. It's going to be 850 to win 500. Let's throw it over to Damon. It's Werdum versus Nogueira.
I got the same pick, Fabricio Werdum. I mean, these two guys met back in 2006 when Werdum was still, you know, kind of getting his legs under him in terms of mixed martial arts. And at the time, Nogueira was one of the top heavyweights in the world. But a lot has changed since that time. Obviously, Nogueira has aged many, many years since that time with some of the knockouts and some of the wear and tear he's put on his body over the years. Whereas, you know, what Case said, you know, Verdum's kind of coming into his own recently, especially with his last two fights in the UFC. Looked fantastic against Roy Nelson, a really dominant performance over Mike Russo. And then when you look at the Alistair Overeem fight, that's the one oddball fight in his last six or seven where he hasn't looked really good. And even in that fight, on the feet, I thought he was outstriking Alistair Overeem. So I like him in this fight, especially on the feet. I think he can stop Nogueira's takedowns, and I think he can outpoint Nogueira on the feet. I don't know that he'll win by knockout necessarily, but I think he can go out there and definitely win a solid decision.
Okay, so Damon also agrees. It's Werdum at minus 170. It's going to be 850 to win $500. So both of our experts do pick Werdum over Nogueira. My personal thoughts are it's going to be a very competitive fight. I expect a very close decision either way. It's kind of hard to lay that juice, but I do think the public is going to agree with you. I'm going to adjust the odds since both of you guys favor Werdum as well. The new line when it hits 5-9 is going to be minus 180. The comeback on Nogueira is going to be plus 140. Make sure you guys stay tuned as we break fight 20 on MMA Oddsbreaker tomorrow.